Hi Dan, so you asked if these modern day communities of practice can ever be an adequate replacement for religious institutions and all the good stuff that they bring about. And I would like to start off by pointing out that religious institutions are already a bit of a community of practice. They're a bunch of like-minded people coming together with similar ideas and similar goals. There might be some differences, but broad strokes, they are generally kind of all on the same page. Now, one of the big differences that I think people perceive religious institutions as having as different from, other things like a community of jugglers or whatever, is that religious institutions in general view themselves more as outside the community, as shepherds of that community, making sure, it stays healthy and whole and happy and all of that sort of stuff. And that sort of seems to be the case. Clergymen, coming from my Roman Catholic background, didn't get married because they were already married to the church. They were outside of the community, watching it. Whereas a lot of these other sort of communities are a subset of a larger community, and they acted within that and focused mostly on themselves, on things pertaining directly to them. Which leads me to another point. You mentioned that this is the golden age of communities of practice, and in many ways, yes, it is, but communities of practice have always sort of existed. You go back in time, and there's things like, the guilds, or various colleges and libraries like the School of Athens or the Library of Alexandria, where people could come together and discuss ideas or talk about things that pertain to them, the making of a better axle or the new road system or, whatever happened to be something that was within their worldview. And that made these old communities of practice very insular, and a lot more insular than churches and other religious organizations tended to be. So you have this contrast between religious institutions attempting to look out for the community as a whole, and then you have these other subsets of those communities concentrating mostly on themselves. Nowadays, the breadth of a community is essentially global, so you have a wide variety of people from all different backgrounds and walks of life coming together. And that sort of leads into another point, which religions tend to be fairly static. So, and then these communities of practice tend to be fairly agile. You get differing opinions or different ideas or, just huge paradigm shifts sweeping through the community, and doesn't require any massive change to the community itself. It sort of embraces all of it all at once. With religious institutions, if there was a big change in how people thought within that community, they generally had to splinter off into their own separate community. If you look at message boards, yeah, sure, there'll be, areas talking about specifics of what's, going on in that community, but there's always somewhere near the bottom of message boards, there's always a section that's like miscellaneous or chit chat or whatever, where, it's all about conversations that don't necessarily have to do with the topic at hand. They can talk about, whatever they want. And so this allows you a bit of freedom and a little bit of openness. You can, once you get tired of talking about the essentials of what's going on in the community, you can hop over and hear about somebody else's, love of baking, or get into a conversation about a specific disaster relief fund or something like that. And so it gives you an opportunity. Like I said before, if you live too far away from somebody, it's hard to get together with them and talk about anything other than what was going on. Now you can talk about all this other stuff, and so you can be more aware of things that are going around you as a community. So let's say, a bunch of, let's say jugglers or whatever are getting together in Pittsburgh, and one of those people happens to really love baking, and then you hop over and you check out the disaster relief fund idea, and suddenly you realize, hey, we could have, a bake sale during the day for that relief fund, and then get together at night, and that way we as a community can come together and do something rather than just, get drunk at a bar and talk about the stuff we like. You can do something a lot more important and something that has a bigger impact. And that sort of leads into my final point. These communities of practices are becoming a lot less insular. They care a lot more about things that are going on in the world around them. First of all, very literally and directly, because the communities are so spread out, if anything is going on in the world, it's more likely to pertain to somebody within that group, so you're more likely to have some sort of a connection with it. But more sort of ephemerally, you have the idea, you see all these different people coming together with similar ideas and similar mindsets, and so you're open to the idea that people who are radically different than you are still on some basic level similar to you, which means that when you see something in the news about some disaster somewhere or whatever, you're not going to just see it as images on a screen pertaining to something far off that has nothing to do with you. You're more likely to empathize with these people because you see them as people. So to wrap up, I would like to say that yes, communities of practice can be an adequate replacement, or rather I would like to say they can replicate the good things that religious institutions have done, in that they can look at themselves in a community and see things larger than the context of their own particular interests, and there's a whole sense of caring and concern for that community that sort of arises from that. And furthermore, there's a lot of stuff that can be done as outreach. People are a lot more willing to do that, and more so they have the capability to organize efforts to help something that doesn't necessarily pertain to them exactly. So yes, communities of practice can adequately replicate the good things that religious institutions have done.